The following course is designed to communicate the steps required to complete a Gauge Master load cell calibration and to verify Gauge Master functionality. The Gauge Master feature uses a load cell on one of the opener gauge wheels, measuring the actual gauge wheel force exerted on the ground. Gauge Master is available on units equipped with PLR openers only. The load cell equipped opener is located on the front row, near the center of the drill. The opener with the sensor can be identified by the cable that runs from the back of the gauge wheel spindle up to the main trunk of the drill harness. By controlling your openers to a set opener down pressure, you are providing a fixed amount of downwards force on the coulter disc for penetrating the soil. This ensures consistent seed depth is achieved. PackMaster is a similar feature which is available on non-PLR opener types. PackMaster uses a load cell on one of the opener packer wheels to measure the actual packing force being exerted on the ground. Although the two features operate in different ways, they are controlled within the X35 system in the same fashion. Therefore, when accessing Gauge Master adjustments and calibration in the X35, the terminology will refer to PackMaster. Before the Gauge Master feature can accurately measure the amount of force being applied to the gauge wheel, the load cell must be calibrated. It should also be recalibrated if the load cell is replaced. The following video will guide you through the necessary steps to achieve a proper Gauge Master load cell calibration, then to verify functionality. Enable the Lift Master feature by selecting Implement, Apollo Cedar, Cedar, Drill Control, Lift Master. Open the Drill Control and enable. In this example, a lower time of 6 seconds is being set. This value will vary depending on the preferences of the implement operator. Select the PackMaster tab and enable PackMaster. Enter the following settings into the PackMaster section. Change control type to pack force. Change second display to pack force. Ensure the drive is set to the channel of the PackMaster ECU that the harness is plugged into. In this example, drive 4. The preset values allow for immediate adjustment of the gauge wheel force from the operation screen. In this example, 90 pounds is entered. If the operator has a setting preference for continued operation, enter the appropriate value. In this example, the second preset is set to 150 pounds. Again, if the operator has a setting preference for immediate continued operation, enter the appropriate value. The increment value allows for the gauge wheel pressure to be increased or decreased from the operation screen. In this example, an increment of 10 pounds is entered. If the operator has a setting preference, enter the appropriate value. Minimum calibration load, maximum calibration load, minimum calibration value, and maximum calibration value will be generated during a successful calibration. The minimum values should be lower than the maximum values. New systems come with a calibration tag secured to the gauge wheel that is equipped with the load sensor. The values on the tag are considered to be a good starting point. They can be manually entered. However, an in-field calibration may still be required if results are inconsistent. When calibrating Gauge Master, the drill model should be set to 3820, as the drill will be equipped with PLR openers. By setting the drill model, the appropriate calibration parameters and alarm settings will be automatically applied. With the drill model set to 3820, the opener type should default to PLR automatically. Once the setup steps are complete, select Close in the top right corner to navigate back to the operating screen. Lift the openers, exit the tractor, and close the safety valve. Place a block under the gauge wheel. The block must be large enough to ensure the coulter disc and packer wheel stay off the ground when the openers are lowered. It is worth noting that an excessively tall block may skew the calibration. Once the block has been placed, the remainder of the calibration process can be done from the cab. Open the safety valve and return to the cab. Engage the opener hydraulic circuit and lower the openers onto the block. With the cedar screen on the main page of the X35, open the Configuration tab, then select Packmaster Calibration. With the openers in the raised position, place the hydraulics into the neutral position. Ensure PLR openers are set to depth setting 8, then advance the calibration wizard. The first set point is with zero drive power and the opener hanging. It may be necessary to wait as the displayed hydraulic pressure drops. It may take several minutes for the pressure to bleed out of the circuit and the display to show zero. Once it does, advance the calibration wizard. Enter the sensor load in pounds. If the openers are raised, the sensor load should display zero. Advance the calibration wizard. Engage the tractor hydraulics to lower the openers. This step is measuring the load on the gauge wheel with the weight of the opener only. Wait for the advance arrow to appear and for the hydraulic pressure to stabilize. Advance the calibration wizard. A sensor load of 250 pounds needs to be entered as the weight of the opener at this point. Advance the calibration wizard. The system will display that the PAC-4 sensor calibration has been completed. Select OK to exit the calibration wizard. If there are any difficulties during the calibration process, please consult Section 13 of the X35 Console Operator's Manual. Enter the setup screen by touching the wrench symbol. Verify that the minimum and maximum calibration loads and the minimum and maximum calibration values have automatically populated. It is recommended that you record these numbers on the Drill Control Quick Reference Guide for future use. The following steps will guide you through a functional test of GauGemaster. Drive desired speed, lower the openers, and select preset 1. Verify that the hydraulic pressure is adjusting and that the display is changing to show the preset pressure. Look backwards at the openers to see if they are stable in the ground. With insufficient hydraulic pressure, they will bounce. In this example, we can observe that the hydraulic pressure is insufficient and the system cannot hold it steady. Select preset 2. Verify that the hydraulic pressure is climbing and the pressure is changing to display the preset pressure. With excessive hydraulic pressure, the system may possibly lift the frame. Downforce should be set only as high as necessary to achieve desired seed depth and consistent gauge wheel pressure. For more information on field adjustments, consult Section 8 of the I-Series Frame-Mounted Cedar Operator's Manual, or Section 5 of the 3820 Paralink Coulter Drill Operator's Manual. The drill control can be displayed in the mini view or from the main page of the X35. To ensure a basic familiarity with the tabs, they will be covered now. This window displays the desired downforce. For the PLR opener, this is actually the gauge wheel downforce. The decrease and increase tabs will adjust the force applied by the gauge wheel in the increment selected in setup. In this example, the increment was set at 10 pounds. Preset 1 and 2 are located here. In this example, preset 1 is set at 90 pounds and preset 2 is set at 150 pounds. The tab with the two arrows in a circle will turn GauGemaster on and off. When engaged, the tab will turn green. The tab directly below, when displaying a large A, indicates the system will automatically adjust the hydraulic pressure required to maintain the requested gauge wheel downforce. If the tab is pressed, it is now set to manual, displaying a hand. Now the operator must press the plus or minus tabs to increase or decrease the pressure. Values displayed in the top right of the window show the actual gauge wheel downforce in pounds, and just below this value is the opener circuit hydraulic pressure in PSI. When set to automatic, the system will adjust the hydraulic pressure to maintain the requested gauge wheel downforce. The lift lower tab, also referred to as the lift master button, controls the opener position. Red arrows with a gray background indicates the drill is in the lifted position. Green arrows with a yellow background indicates that the lift lower tab is enabled, but the drill is still in the lifted position. Green arrows with an orange background indicates that the drill is moving to the lowered position. Green arrows with a green background indicates that the drill is in the lowered position. If the button is grayed out, the LiftMaster drive is not configured, or ECU communication has not been achieved. The TrackMaster tab links the LiftMaster system to the master switch state. When TrackMaster is turned on, the openers will lower when the master switch is engaged, and the Lift Lower tab will show green. When the master switch is turned off, the openers will lift, and the Lift Lower tab background will show yellow, indicating that the openers are in the up or ready state. Should you encounter any difficulties during the calibration process, or should you wish to review additional information, refer to Section 13 of the X35 Console Operator's Manual.